The new Samsung Galaxy S6 will have simultaneous voice and data, but only on 3G or LTE when LTE switches back to 3G when a call is initiated, but it will. However, we have no idea how it is done technically, but we do not imagine a high-end phone not allowing voice and data at the same time. At the other end, Moto X 2014 and Droid Turbo are both high-end phones and don't have the feature of simultaneous voice and data. It may be that the phone will have two separate antennas like the Note 4. As I remember reading that having one antenna is what most manufacturers will be going for in the near future. But I think no phone will have two antennas anymore because carriers are now moving towards voice over LTE, so unless you're in a VoLTE area. But still have my fingers crossed that we'll have two antennas in the S6 since the Note 4, which is a relatively recent phone from Samsung, had them incorporated. Well, it more or less depends on the carrier too. Verizon seems to retain dual antennas on their phones, whereas Sprint on the other hand, not so much. The Note 4 for example has dual radios, but you can't use both on Sprint at the same time, at least not until they fully enable VoLTE. Unlikely that S6 can do SVoLTE because the FCC test docs say as much and because VZW is moving toward VoLTE the need is not there. 5.1 Android has the VoLTE switch built in. With GSM providers it's a little different. For example, AT&T will drop you to HSPA and during a call to support data/voice if a call came to your phone. It's a loss, yes, but for the OEMs it reduces cost and perhaps saves some battery life. That's the thing. Verizon's Moto X, 2014, and Droid Turbo both have only one antenna. But as already discussed, the Note 4 had retained dual antennas, so I'm hopeful that Samsung did the same with the S6. Definitely a shame, but that is the trend for CDMA carriers these days. HTC M9 is the same way.